What's up, what's up? It's the original Dirty Rotten, Jeru the Damaja, Brooklyn, East New York in the house.
You want a front wall? Jump up and get bucked. The original Dirty Rotten's fucking
me,
shit up.
Today, the state of hip-hop is really good because it's flourishing. So, some guys might have complaints about it's like this or it's like that, but for me, it's all good because I've already carved out my niche and who I am. So it's wonderful because hip-hop represents worldwide music. So it's great to me. I'm good. The secret to surviving the game is to be a ninja. No, but seriously, it's just, I think, making good music. Because you see, good music is timeless. You understand what I'm saying? And doing it from the heart. Because anything you do from the heart that you want to do, it's going to last. My early influence in the game, it was so many, because to me, when I grew up, I think was one of the best eras in hip-hop. We had so many dope people. Like, people always talk about, like, the golden era. They talk about myself, the Nas's, the Biggies and all that. But you got to think, before us, there were dudes like Kool G Rap, Big Daddy Kane, KRS-One, and they were the guys who actually influenced us. And that's what I think the difference is today. It's like the younger kids, I don't think they pay as much homage to who came before them. And when they pay homage to who came before them, it's probably like 2 or 3 years before them, not 10 years or whatever, you know? So yeah, so like I said, G-Rap, Kane, EPMD, it's too many to name. Run DMC, Third Bass, Slick Rick, and that's what it was, that we had so many different styles of MCs that it allowed you to be able to create your own style from having so many different things to pick from. It's like if you're gonna cook, if you only have one or two ingredients, it's not gonna taste as good as if you have a bunch of ingredients to choose from, you know? And that's all it was. We had lots of ingredients to choose from. And yeah, that's it. To me, storytelling ability, flow, the way you express yourself, your body language, and all that has to do with it. Because my mother used to always tell us when we were young, it's not what you say, it's so much as how you say it. So that's just it, the unique way that you express yourself would make a top lyricist to me. Like some guys that I wouldn't even necessarily like as much as other guys, but the way that they express themselves, like guys like Biz Markie, it wasn't the best lyrics in the world, but the way he said it made it dope, you know? The strangest place I've ever performed. It had to be in the whorehouse. No, I'm just joking. I'm a dickhead sometimes. Wow, that's a good question. Okay, one time somewhere in England, I forget what town it is, they had no stage or anything. Two times, I guess. One time in England, I performed on my record crate in a club where the ceiling was just shy of your head, standing on the record crate. So maybe the ceilings were about 7 feet, if that high. And the backstage, in order to get to it, you had to squeeze between the wall and go through the wall to get to it. It was pretty strange. Ho ho ho! Nihonjin koten desu. Jeru the Damaja, of course. Really, I don't listen to too much hip hop today because I think a lot of things about music is one thing about music, not a lot of things, but music is relative. So I can't really relate to some of the stuff now because it is a different generation and the things that they feel and they talk about is not necessarily things that I know about because I'm traveling the world, I'm doing different grown-up things, you know. I don't care too much about pink shirts and, you know, orange sneakers and stuff like that. So, and spending money on chicks, not my thing. My uncle, Bunky, God rest the dead, he told me, if you want to be a hustler, you have to speak the people's language. And being a hustler is not necessarily selling drugs or anything like that. You can hustle anything. Like Mike hustles shows, and he hustles clothes. And you have to speak the people's language and know what they're about. Because I can have something perfectly relevant and profound to say, but if you can't understand where I'm coming from, it means nothing. I'll tell you what I dislike about the music industry now. The internet, because everybody's an expert, right? Like, I'll tell you a funny story. One time I was reading the Wikipedia about myself, and I saw something that was wrong. So I changed it. Do you know 20 minutes later I went back and somebody changed it back? I was like, damn, they know me better than me. Two, I dislike the fact that it's so easy to make music now. It's a good thing, it's a blessing and a curse at the same time. Because it's a good thing if you're very creative, and it's a good thing for kids who couldn't necessarily get into the studio and make records and things of that nature. But it's a bad thing because anybody with a computer and Fruity Loops thinks that they're a producer and an MC. So that's what I dislike about it. The biggest misconception about Jeru the Damaja is like, I'm this super serious, anti-everything type guy, when I'm really just a big kid that likes to have fun. The reason I made records the way that I made records, because my mother told me, which is another good piece of advice, she was like, you really have the opportunity to be heard. So if you're going to be heard, you should say something, and say something important. Don't let that, because fame is fleeting. So if you're going to be remembered, if you're going to go down in the annals of history, you should say something. So that's it. It's jerudedamager.com. You can catch me on Twitter, even though I don't snitch on myself on Twitter. No twitching, you know what I mean? Like, it got me kind of like, I was weirded out by Twitter, you know, because at first, you know, you don't know what it is. They're like, Twitter, Twitter, Twitter. And then when I saw what it was, when I first signed up, I was like, oh, I'm not doing this. I'm from the old school. I don't tell people where I'm at and what I'm doing at that moment. But if you don't like me, you could be waiting for me outside the club, you know? So, but Twitter is Jeru the Damaja, or at Jeru the Damaja. That's J-E-R-U-T-H-E-D-A-M-A-J-A, just like the website. So, you know, that's what it is. But it's hot in here, not Nelly's song. And we about to bounce. Check it out. It's your man, the original. Dirty Rotten, in case you've forgotten, and you hearing this by word of mouth. You know what I'm saying? Capacity Entertainment, holding it up. Peace.